misconceptions that has been thought about manatees in Alabama and other areas in the Northern Gulf is that they're somehow lost or exploring and they're not supposed to be here. And that's kind of why we started the Manatee Sighting Network here at Dauphin Island Sea Lab. They're broadly using habitat. Every one of these dots is where a manatee has been sighted, so they're really broadly using the coastline. And they're coming here in greater numbers than they have in the past. And we just ask people who are on the water, you know, live on the water, work on the water, maybe they like to go fishing or boating, if they are seeing the manatees anyway, to let us know about it.
I have lived here in Alabama my whole life and never heard of a manatee, never knew what a manatee was until I went to SeaWorld. Saw them there, saw them in Epcot. Then, years later, we bought some property on the river, the same river that we have traveled every weekend for recreational activities. One day, I saw on the news that there were manatees here, and I recognized the background, knew where they were, so we came out, went to that spot, turned the motor off, noticed bubbles everywhere, and all of a sudden they came up to the top and I was hooked.
Since our research is publicly based, right, it's citizen science, so everyday people seeing manatees, we want people to know what they should do if they see a manatee, how they should treat the manatee, and also to keep a lookout for manatees, because a lot of people don't even think about, I'm boating in Alabama, that there's manatees here.
I want them to know that we have manatees. These are not just for sightseeing. They need to be courteous of these creatures that God has given us. And when they come through in their boats, they need to be, see, look at there. They need to be observant of what's going on under these waters.
So a few tips that we always give people to be able to look for manatees is wear polarized sunglasses, you can see better on the water. Designate a manatee spotter. If you're driving the boat and you have a passenger, have them be the person keeping a lookout for manatees or any kind of debris that might get in your way when you're boating, right? So this number is, the 1-866 number is a 24-hour toll-free hotline. It's one of the main ways that we get our sighting reports. And these signs are actually a collaboration that we've done with Save the Manatee Club to distribute these metal dock signs to people who live on the waterways or maybe local marinas or businesses. So if you see one of these signs, if you're out on the water, should definitely be your clue that manatees are in the area, or at least a manatee has been seen in that area in the past. Sometimes it's a very subtle sign. You won't, even though it's a big animal, you're not going to see a big sign that it's there. And if you do come across a manatee, the best rule of thumb we always tell people is give them plenty of space. If you're changing their behavior, that's not good. We want the manatees to behave normally and for people to observe from a distance.
We look for disturbances on the top of the water, a lot of rippling. If they're playing or mating, it's very easy to find them. There's something happening right over here, which could possibly be, see that?
In our area, we see manatees really broadly use habitat. So a lot of people compare manatees to like whales and dolphins that are spend time in salt water and are out in the Gulf of Mexico. And while we do see animals that travel along the Gulf of Mexico, where we see them more concentrated in our area is in our estuaries and river systems. And it's because they really go where the food goes.
They like to eat the grass along here. That's why it's very important that people do not throw their trash in this water. They use fishing line, bottles, cans, because it gets hung up in this grass, and the manatees are very curious and they will eat it or they will get entangled in the fishing line, and that's life-threatening.
We're out on in the Dog River area right now, which is really prime manatee habitat in the Mobile Bay area. So what makes it such great manatee habitat is it's shallow water, it's very quiet, and there's a lot of vegetation, both emergent vegetation along the shorelines and a lot of submerged vegetation. And manatees eat a lot of vegetation every day, so when we get to see a lot of vegetation like this, we definitely expect to see animals in the area.
Just to show you, these are some examples of the submerged aquatic vegetation that manatees eat in our area. So
So these are lower salinity freshwater, brackish water vegetation. So in Alabama, typically we see manatees from about April through October. It all depends on temperature, but usually animals that are here into December, January, we start to worry about their safety because manatees are a subtropical species, and so they do succumb to cold stress in prolonged periods in cold water. So typically, April through October is our main sighting season, and kind of the warmer the weather, the more manatees we see and the larger groups of manatees that we see.
We had one that we noticed when it would come up to the surface, it looked like part of its paddle was missing. But the other day we were able to get really good pictures of it, and pretty much most of its paddle is gone and is full of scars, and obviously it looks like a boat strike, and it's very sad, but that manatee is able to get around and is traveling with its buddies. In the past, we only had a couple of manatees, it seemed like, at least that's all we ever saw. Yesterday, we saw a dozen. The more manatees we have, the more manatee fatalities we could have. So we need to be careful with that, because the areas that we're seeing them, more and more people are finding out about them. They're coming and watching, and most are very respectful. But then you have the people that fly through the river, they're out for recreational purposes, and they are totally ignorant to what is underneath this water.
So a big part of our mission here at the Manatee Sighting Network is to conduct research, but also to promote education and outreach, to raise awareness for manatees in our area, and talk to people about, you know, what they should do if they see a manatee. And that's something that we've worked really closely with Save the Manatee Club on. Save the Manatee Club works with us on the Adopt a Manatee program, so you can actually adopt an Alabama manatee named Bama, who is the first manatee that was ever tagged in Alabama waters, and who comes back regularly to Alabama year after year. And so if you adopt Bama, a portion of those proceeds come back to support our education and outreach mission here at Dauphin Island in Alabama.